Lacey here with the Sweet Pea Chef, and I know how breakfast can be a hassle and super difficult to do on those busy mornings, especially when all you want to do is just grab something and run out the door. So how about today I show you how to make freezer breakfast sandwiches that you can just grab and go out the door, be happy, healthy, and nourished, and it's going to be so tasty. So let's get started. One of the great things about freezer breakfast sandwiches is just how versatile they are. Today, we're gonna be using whole wheat English muffins, some eggs, some sliced ham, and some cheddar cheese, but you can use or take out anything you want in here. You can change up the protein, the bread, anything you're wanting. All right, so we're gonna start off with toasting our English muffins. And I get whole wheat English muffins here. I make sure they say whole grain in the label, so make sure you're looking at those ingredient labels when you're picking these out. And we're gonna go ahead and divide them in half, and then we're gonna toast all of them. We're making 12 freezer breakfast sandwiches today, so I'm gonna be toasting 24 halves of these. I like to toast the English muffins because I think it adds a better flavor and also makes them hold up a little bit better in the microwave when you heat it back up later on. Once you get all of these toasted, go ahead and set them aside to cool. Now we're gonna get our eggs prepared. I like making a little egg omelet, and for each sandwich I use one egg. And it's so easy to do. All you have to do is in a small mixing bowl, just combine one egg with a little bit of sea salt and a little bit of black pepper and whisk all of that until it's fully mixed. Then we're gonna heat just a little bit of olive oil in a small pan over medium heat. Then we're gonna add in our egg mixture and then just let it set for a minute. We're basically just gonna swirl this around by tilting the pan just a little bit. We're wanting the egg mixture to completely cover the bottom of the pan and form a circle. Then all we're gonna do is let it cook for about 2 to 3 minutes. We're not gonna flip it, we're not doing anything special, we're just letting this cook all the way through. You can tell it's fully cooked through when it's no longer jiggly and it's not as shiny. Then carefully release any of the egg from the side of the pan using a soft spatula. Then we're gonna carefully fold our egg in half. Then fold it in half one more time, and that is how we're gonna make each of our 12 eggs for our freezer breakfast sandwiches. Go ahead and repeat with the remaining eggs. If you wanted to use egg whites instead of a full egg for this to have a little bit less fat and a little bit more protein, that is a great option as well. The only issue is that it's not gonna hold up as well when you fold everything. If you're okay with a little bit of a scramble, egg whites will be fine. In order to make this process as fast as possible and to be efficient, I like to have my eggs prepped ahead of time as I'm cooking my eggs. So when I have one egg mixture getting poured into my pan, I also have a backup egg mixture. And then while the eggs are cooking, I'm getting my next backup egg mixture together so that when I can flip one out, I can then add a new one in. And I just keep that going the whole time as like an assembly line. That makes this process really fast. All right, so now we have our English muffins toasted and our eggs ready to go and cooling. So next we need to get our ham and our cheese ready. So what I do is I like to divide everything out and have it ready to go so I can have a really fast assembly line. So with my ham, I go ahead and I weigh it using a food scale, and I weigh between 1 and 2 ounces of ham for every sandwich, depending on how much you want to add in there. So I go ahead and do that for the ham, and then I do the exact same thing for my cheese. I weigh out 1/2 ounce of cheese per sandwich. That way, when I have everything ready to go, I can put it all in. I know everything's gonna be the exact same. It's gonna be the exact same nutritional profile with every sandwich, and it's gonna taste the same too. Okay, now it's time to assemble our tasty freezer breakfast sandwiches. So grab a square sheet of aluminum foil and lay it on a flat surface. Over that, put a similar sized square sheet of saran wrap. And then we're gonna start with our first bottom half of our toasted English muffin. You can set the other one aside for right now. On top of our English muffin, we're going to layer our sliced ham. A lot of people are worried about ham being added to their food, thinking that it's too high in fat or salt or whatever. Definitely when you go to pick it out at the store, ask the deli person to give you the no sugar added, low sodium hams, because that's gonna be a very healthy option for you. It has a really good nutritional makeup for you as well. If you don't want the ham, you can replace the ham with some deli sliced turkey or chicken or whatever you prefer. Next, layer our egg omelet and then follow that up with a layer of our cheese. Then we can top that off with the remaining half of our toasted English muffin. Then we're gonna wrap it really tightly with the Saran wrap, and then wrap it once again with the aluminum foil. The combination of the Saran wrap and the aluminum foil is gonna make sure that these stay very fresh and ready to go and grab, and that they'll also last for a good 3 months in the freezer. So I definitely recommend you taking the time to make sure that you wrap these well. I recommend gathering all of your breakfast sandwiches in one place, either in some sort of container or into a Ziploc bag. I use a 1 gallon size freezer safe Ziploc bag, and I label it so that I know when I go into my freezer, I can just quickly grab what I'm looking for. Then repeat with the remaining ingredients until you have 12 delicious freezer ready wrapped breakfast sandwiches. Then on those busy mornings and you're ready to go and enjoy one of these tasty sandwiches, go ahead and grab one of those sandwiches, unwrap it from the Saran wrap and the aluminum foil, place it on a plate and microwave it for about 1.5 to 2 minutes until the cheese is melted and it's all cooked all the way through. It is a delicious and tasty sandwich. If you wanted to put it in the oven instead, just preheat your oven to 350 degrees, toss it in there for about 10 to 15 minutes until it's completely heated through. Each one of these breakfast sandwiches is just 309 calories and it's full of fiber and protein and deliciousness, making it a really great prep ahead breakfast. Thanks so much for watching. I hope this breakfast sandwich recipe makes your morning so much easier on those busy mornings. To make it even easier, also check out my freezer breakfast burritos post for another super easy make ahead breakfast option. Thanks so much. Make sure to subscribe and I will see you next time. Bye-bye.